supply shock, a demand shock, a financial market shock, an international trade shock. It is every shock that you can imagine studying, all coming together.
Some of the modeling done by my colleagues showed that if nothing was done, if we live life as normal, then after about 80 days, we would see almost 1.2 million infections in Singapore.
We become very myopic, we become very self-centered, we find it very difficult to think about others, we find it very hard to make long-range plans. And in this situation, we are being asked to rise above ourselves and be better for the community and for society.
We rediscover our neighborhood. We rediscover our cultural roots, our ecological environment, and many other things. And that, for me, it could be a chance, a new chance for the engagement of citizens in their own environment.
The ability to transmission is higher, COVID-19, than SARS. So SARS disappeared, but now most of the immunologists believe this virus probably will remain among human beings for a long time.
Now what we see with that pandemic is people being forced into isolation. Isolation and loneliness have been studied, and studies have shown chronically lonely people have genetic manifestations. Genes are turned on, genes are turned off just from being chronically lonely.
So the commitment of the ministries first is safe school opening. When they reopen, it should be safe and following all sanitation protocols. And the second one, you have to reach the unreached.
After the pandemic, many of government dearly wanted to try digital-based learning solution, continuous learning solution right away. But usually government doesn't have any system to spend the money for this type of R&D or development.
There's a fantastic UNICEF report from 1999 that argues that a crisis response should be seen as a development opportunity. And I think that's very true here. We should be using this moment of investment and focus to build systems and lay the groundwork for a more equitable education system when COVID starts, the curve starts flattening, and hopefully there'll be a post-COVID reality.
What the world has witnessed during the pandemic is not so much an indictment of globalization, but a reaffirmation of interdependence among the nations and peoples of the world.
At some point, years from now, some student of epidemiology, economics, and statistics will run a regression. And they will say, they will look at the world and they will say, look at these countries that were called autocracies. Look at these countries that are called Western-style liberal democracies. Correlate that with the number of deaths, the rate of infection across these societies. And they will say, how does this compare to what is supposed to happen?